Meanwhile, residents of Bomwale and Bomasanta parishes in Bulucheke sub-county have started demolishing their houses, removing ashes and shifting their property to Bulucheke and Bunamobi Town Council for safety. This follows the continuous shifting of soils in their area, which they fear will soon lead to a landslide. Shifting in soils is a result of continuous rains. We have the report.
The Elgon region has seen deadly mudslides over the years that has left scores dead and thousands homeless. Residents are living in fear of a looming landslide. Recently, Prime Minister Robina Nabanja visited the area and proved that indeed soils on the slopes had begun to shift, something that usually happens before a mudslide. A warning. This time, residents are not taking any chances. Some of them have started to demolish their homes and shift property and their families out of the way. Bosco Matanda Masaya, also a resident, says fears have spread within the community, which is why many are choosing to move so they do not fall victim.
Landslides, which has made people to run away from their home village. Mm.
What are they doing?
Now they have been, most of them have been taken to camps where they have been centered, but the remaining are just there doing nothing because there's nowhere to go. Because they are seeing some water which is coming with soil, which is almost clearing their homes. So they had to decide to run away from those places.
Another resident, Modesta Kuloba, and mother of five, says she constructed her house just 2 years ago, but now she has to move. She has removed the iron sheets off the roof to at least save them. She says the movement of soils has already destroyed her tomato garden. Bududa District Woman Member of Parliament and Minister of State for Karamoja Affairs Agnes Nandutu says although the government had abolished the system of camps, in this situation, people have been allowed at Bumwalia Primary School.
You cannot be strict on disasters. It has happened. So people had to run out of the mountains and camp in a school. But we are not encouraging the camp to be there forever. We are keeping them there temporarily as we planned for a home, for homes for them to go.
While officiating at the launch of relief distribution by Uganda Red Cross at Bulucheke grounds, Nandutu promised that the government will do whatever it can to protect the people. She said government is planning to resettle some of the people within the district to avoid what happened to those who were relocated to Kiriandongo.
We have been told about 100 and so houses that are being completed now because the first phase settled and now they were preparing for the for another phase. But since the disaster has now emerged, we have to do it very fast so that we can settle some few families. There are very many who have been displaced. Not all of them will go to Bulambuli. So that is why we are telling government, let's find a solution within the district.
Luseke Constituency Member of Parliament Isaac Mudoi asked the government to find a lasting solution to this problem.
We are able to read the signals in time, such that we are at the people. And by alerting the people, we can be able to minimize damage to the property where possible, but also to avoid death. So it has been a continuous process. And that will continue until we get a permanent solution, like the minister has said.
Report by Wilfred Masaba for the news.